I met Michael, I think about 4 years ago. And so, I don't even remember how we met. Actually, I met him previous to that. I was kept getting emails from somebody telling me to get on this phone call and we're going to see if we can lower the price of gasoline. And then he would say, whoa, we lowered the price of gasoline. And then we're going to get on a phone call and change something in the world. And I remember thinking initially that maybe this guy is a magician. Did I trust him? You know, there's an inherent trust, in my mind, there's a stipulation that I have, because I do know that group energy works, and he was missing one of the important criterias, which was for the highest good of all concerned and honoring free will. And he didn't include that in what he was doing. But I didn't think he could do too much damage lowering gas prices, and I didn't hold a judgment. And then I met him. I know where he came by my booth. I had a booth at the Conscious Life Expo. And then we went out, we talked, and we actually had a great energy between us. One of those energies where we were spontaneously meeting, this is my way of understanding it, spontaneously meeting in the vibratory field, which I could feel, and I knew he was feeling. And there was an excitement about, is there a way to co-create with this energy? I know that a human energy field is constantly flowing. It's constantly flowing. It gets bigger, it gets smaller, it connects with somebody, it disconnects. And one of the things I've learned in my own experience is that when human energies connect together in free will and they put an intention on that energy, it becomes extremely powerful. And it's a way that the universe rearranges itself. And in fact, I thought Michael actually came to one of our Sunday calls, and I was excited with the prospect of working with him because I recognized a powerful creator. I also knew he was counseling people. He was had certain techniques of helping people reach a higher point of not accomplishment. Accomplishment could be, but effectiveness. How to use yourself more effectively in the world. So actually, I thought we were moving into that, and then we kind of just lost track of each other. It's been now quite a long time, a few years, since we've been in touch with each other. And I happen to be sitting here at the Las Vegas Convention Center, and I came here because there's a convention, and I have a potential movie project with Barry Morrow. And I said, maybe I'll find someone here that synchronistically that can help with that movie. And the convention was over today, and I'm sitting in the lounge outside the Starbucks, and guess what? Michael walks by me, our eyes catch, and he had a camera, and here we are. Impossible synchronicity. This event is huge. It has 100,000 people. It's spread over the entire convention center, you know, and there's like six huge rooms or something where the convention is taking place. And Michael walks by and our eyes catch, and we had that energy that probably connected with us when we originally met each other.